guys, it's Mariam. So today I thought I would just sit down and chat with you all about some of my July favorites. It's been a while since I've actually done a favorites video, so I thought, hey, why not do one for July? So grab a cup of tea or coffee if you don't like tea, and let's just jump right into the video. The first product I want to share with you all is the Skin Physics Dragon's Blood Facial Sculpting Gel. This is literally such a good moisturizer to wear underneath foundation because I feel like it just makes your makeup just like more put together and nice, and it also doesn't make it look cakey. I've also found that this product is really good at reducing redness on your face, which is absolutely incredible because I literally sometimes look like an absolute tomato, and the redness on my face makes my acne stand out even more. So this product is literally amazing, and I think it is so worth the money. Next favorite is the Body Blends Coffee Buff Face and Body Scrub. This is so luxurious, and I would highly recommend you guys to try out a coffee scrub because it is such a great exfoliant and it is so good for your skin. It makes your skin feel super soft, and it also helps to get rid of any dead skin. And this product is actually all natural, vegan, and it's made in Australia. My next beauty favorite is the Mecca Max Eye Max Volumizing Mascara. This has probably been my favorite mascara for a few months now, and I found that this is probably one of the best mascaras I've ever owned, and I'm pretty sure this was like super affordable as well. And the last thing in the beauty category is the MAC NC35 Studio Fix Powder Plus Foundation. Basically, as the name suggests, it's pretty much a powder foundation. Usually for a daily basis, I either wear no makeup at all, or I'll wear BB cream. And sometimes if I want to look more put together, I guess, I'll just pop on a little bit of the powder foundation on top just to make me feel a bit more put together. The next category is fashion, and not gonna lie, I haven't been like super fashionable lately. Like, I've literally been wearing loungewear and leggings for the past few months because here in Melbourne, we are still in lockdown, and to be honest, I don't even know when lockdown is going to be over. But I have been obsessed with this dress lately. It's just a black and white plaid slip dress. It's got like this lace trimming at the end, which I think is such a cute little detail. I really like wearing this underneath a white turtleneck during like the autumn winter time. But during the spring and summer, I could totally just like wear this on its own, maybe with like a denim jacket or something. And then next favorite is this dark lavender shoulder bag. I just think this color is just so pretty, and I literally got this thrifted, so what a steal. This looks so nice. Next are these gorgeous pastel flower earrings from Brit & Co. These earrings are literally the cutest thing ever, and they are so me. Like, if you guys know me, you know how much I love my pastels, especially pink, mint green, and lilac. They're just totally my vibe. And also, these are handmade out of clay from a small Aussie business in Adelaide. I love supporting small businesses, and honestly, Brit & Co's earrings and just accessories in general are such good quality and so cute. Like, if you're super into pastels, definitely go check out Brit & Co. Oh, also, I do have a discount code if you guys do want to check out Brit & Co. I'm pretty sure my discount code is just Mariam10, and that would get you 10% off. And the last thing in the fashion category is this cute little scrunchie from Love From Hole, which is another small Australian brand created by one of my good internet friends, Holly. Definitely go check her out because she has so many cute scrunchies, and she also sells keyrings and earrings, and she also recently came out with like a chapstick holder, which is so unique. Literally, I have never seen anything like that before. I'll actually show you guys what that looks like because it is so cool. So this is the chapstick holder. It's like a little keyring thing that you can hook onto your keys or your backpack or your purse or even like the little hoop in your jeans or something, and you just put your chapstick or lipstick in it, and it is so cool. Like, I've never seen anything like this. But yeah, anyways, this is my favorite scrunchie at the moment. It just goes with so many different things, and I love this little dot print as well. I actually wore this scrunchie with the slip dress, and I think these go really, really well together. All right, so now on to entertainment. I actually have two YouTuber recommendations for you guys. The first one is Julia K. Christ. She recently hit 100k on YouTube, so congrats to her. Her videos are honestly so amazing. If you're super into productivity, college vlogs, how she uses her MacBook, unboxings, how she does her digital art, like all of that kind of stuff. Honestly, I am so obsessed with her videos at the moment. And the second YouTuber recommendation I have is Grace Aria. She's actually a small YouTuber. She has about 4.5k subscribers, I think. And her videos are all about fashion and lifestyle, productivity, challenges, all that kind of videos. And her uploads are very consistent and her video quality is just amazing. Now for TV shows, again, I have two recommendations for you guys. The first one is The Originals. I actually finished this show last night and I was so emotional. Like, I have never been that emotional over a TV show or a movie before, but like that ending of The Originals absolutely broke me. Like, I was literally bawling my eyes out. I'm not even joking. Like, ask my friend Olivia Grace. She knows how emotional I was. But anyways, quick recap of The Originals. It is the spin-off of The Vampire Diaries. And to be honest, I actually prefer The Originals over The Vampire Diaries because the plot of The Originals is so much better than The Vampire Diaries. Don't come for me if you don't agree with me, but I just love The Originals. It follows the original vampire family. So like the first ever vampires to ever exist. One of the original vampires is actually half werewolf. So he's a hybrid and he had a one night stand with this werewolf in The Vampire Diaries. And in The Originals, they find out that that werewolf is pregnant. And then it like follows their kind of life. It has like family values as well as like supernatural things. I don't know. It's really hard to explain, but it's such an amazing show and I highly recommend it. But I would suggest if you're going to watch The Originals, probably watch The Vampire Diaries first because it just makes the experience so much better. And then my second TV show recommendation is actually a reality show, and that is Big Brother Australia. I used to be so obsessed with Big Brother back in the day, and I was so sad when they canceled it back in 2014. So I was so excited when they brought it back this year, but it was a little different this year because they didn't have the audience voting people out every week. Instead, there would be a challenge in the house and then one person would win the challenge and nominate people up for eviction, and then the rest of the housemates get to choose who gets evicted from the people that were nominated. And the finale is when the audience gets to vote for who the winner is out of the three finalists. But yeah, this year's Big Brother is already over. I'm not gonna say any spoilers. I don't want to spoil anything. And my podcast recommendation would be Don't Blame Me by Megan Rinks. This is basically like a little advice podcast in a lighthearted, comedic way, but also in an educational way. If you watch Megan, you know that her personality is like so funny, but she also enjoys helping people. So this podcast is kind of like a mix of both. And some of the advice that she gives is just so hilarious to listen to. And some of the callers that call in, the questions they ask is just like so specific and just so hilarious. And I also do have a few other things that I wanted to mention in this July favorites video, but I don't think they fall under either beauty, fashion, or entertainment. So I'm just gonna call this category other. So I wanted to show you guys my absolute favorite thing at the moment, and it is this little Zen spray. I got this from a giveaway. You guys would have seen me unbox this like a few weeks ago. The spray is meant to make you feel super calm and in that like Zen state, which we absolutely love. Whenever I'm having like a little bit of a self-care day, I like to just spray this around my room. I also like to spray this around my room just before I'm going to sleep so that I'm in my little Zen space and I can fall asleep quicker. And the smell is just really nice. I'm actually going to spray it right now. It's so good. And another thing I also wanted to show you guys is another Brit & Co product, and it is this cute little pastel baby pink pouch. You can either use this as like a little makeup bag or like a little pencil case, literally anything you want to kind of store things in. I actually store some of my colored markers in here. If you guys don't know, I like to do a lot of journaling and scrapbooking, and I use a lot of markers for that, and I had no space to put them anywhere. They were literally just shoved in a drawer. So that's why I'm using this little pouch to store some of my markers. And the last favorite that I'm going to be sharing with you guys is my brand new, well, it's not brand new anymore, a MacBook Pro 2020 13 inch in silver. You guys would have seen me unbox this and also do a review on it, but this is literally my favorite thing ever. I edit my videos on here. I watch Netflix on here. I watch YouTube videos on here. I literally do pretty much everything on this. And this was probably my best investment that I have made this month. And I thought thought a great way to end this July favorites video is by sharing with you all my highlight of this month. The highlight of this month was my 3-year YouTube anniversary and getting to monetize my channel on the same day. One of my goals for 2020 was to monetize my channel this year, and the fact that it happened on my 3-year anniversary meant so much to me, and I'm just so excited. Like, it feels so surreal to be actually having ads in my videos and being able to like get paid pretty much. Obviously, I won't be getting paid for a very long time because the process of monetization and just getting paid in general, it's like you're not really gonna get that much money unless like you're getting like hundreds and thousands of views and all that stuff. But for me, getting paid on YouTube is literally like an added bonus because I just love content creation. It's such a huge part of my life and I have loved it for years and years and years, like way before I even started my YouTube channel in the first place. And I always think if you can get paid to do what you love, 100% go for it. So that concludes my July favorites of the month. Hopefully you guys enjoyed watching this video. If you did, be sure to give it a huge thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel down below. I post new videos every week, and go ahead and follow me on my social medias. I post a ton on there as well. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.